Hello guys, so in this video I'll be going over fundamental algebra. So in fundamental algebra we have variables. Variables are basically letters. So any letter from A to Z will be called a variable when we are talking about algebra. These variables are basically used to represent numbers, and it can be any number. From minus infinity to positive infinity, it can be any number. So if for example we have 3a or z plus 4i plus 10 or j minus 100, so in these the a can represent, a is a variable and it can represent any number. In the same way, z, I, j are all variables which can represent any number from positive infinity to negative infinity, right? And in algebra, the plus, minus or multiply divide sign, so the plus sign or the minus sign, or if we had a number which was 5 divided by z, or if we had 4 multiplied by any number, let's say k, so all these, the operations, the plus, minus and the divide sign and the multiply sign, they are all called operations, right? So these are all called operations, algebraic operations, right? And then we have the a, z, k are all variables. So this z and this k are also variables. So these will be variables, right? And then we have coefficients. So a coefficient is any number which is right next to the variable. So in this case, this 3 is a coefficient. Other examples of coefficient will be that 4j, 5k, 11g, 100f. So 4, 5, 11, 100, because they are right next to the variable, they are the coefficients. So these are called the coefficients, right? And then we have the constant. A constant is any term which is not with a variable. So if we write 10e plus 11 or 100f plus 5, so in both the cases, this 11 and this 5 will be the constants. So these will be the constants, right? Okay, so this form of expression is called a expression because it does not have an equal to sign. So we have two types. We have expressions and we have equations. And the difference between both is that an expression does not have an equal to sign. So it does not have equal to sign, and an equation does have equal to sign. So it has an equal to sign, right? So what I mean by that is that this this example 10e plus 11, so 10e plus 11 is an expression because it has equal to sign. But if we wrote 10e plus 11 is equal to 0, then this will be an equation because it has an equal to sign, right? Okay, so if I'm writing 11f squared, right? Or I'm writing 5x cubed, or I'm writing 10y, right? So in this case, this 11 is the coefficient, this 5 is the coefficient, and this 10 is the coefficient, right? Then this f is the variable, this x is the variable, and this y is the variable. And 2, 3, and when we don't have anything on y, that means that this here we have 1, and this 1 will be the power. So all the things that are highlighted in a yellow are power, right? So then we have linear expressions or equations, right? So we have linear expression or equation. So when we talk about anything which is linear, so the power on any or every variable the power on every variable must be equal to 1. It cannot be less than 1. It cannot be more than 1. The power on the variables must be 1. And the variables must not be multiplied or divided by each other. Nor multiplied or divided by each other. Right? If it's fulfilling both these conditions, then it's a linear equation. So for example, if we have 3x plus 2y plus 4z, so the power on each equation is 1, right? X has a power of 1, y has a power of 1, and z has a power of 1. So this is a linear equation. In the same way, if we had an equation 5z plus 4, so z has a power of 1, right? So it is a linear equation. But if we had an equation which was 4x square plus 3, then it's not a linear equation, because x has a power of 2, right? It has a power of 2. So it's not a linear equation, because the power must be 1. Or if we had an equation which was something like x divided by y, or xz plus 5. So in both these cases, because the variables are being divided or multiplied by each other, so they are also not examples of linear equations, right? Also, if we have a number which is inside a square root or a cube root, then that will also not be a linear equation. So if we had under root z or under cube root y, then they will also not be examples of linear equation, because you will learn this later on in indices, that this basically means that z has a power of half or y has a power of 1/3. So the power, since the power is not 1 over here and over here, they are not fulfilling the conditions which are very important for linear equation. Hence, they are not linear equations, right? So now we will learn how to evaluate these expressions. What I mean by evaluation of these expression is that the examiner basically tells you a certain value for a variable. So we will evaluate expressions. So basically, if we have an expression which is 5x minus 7y, right? And the examiner is saying that evaluate this equation when x is equal to 5 and y is equals to minus 3, right? So let's evaluate this. So what we basically do is we simply just put these values into this expression, right? So we'll do this. So we'll write 5 and then we'll put this value in. So x has the value of 5, so we put 5, then we have minus 7, and the y has the value of minus 3, so we put minus 3 instead of y, and then we just evaluate it. So the bracket basically means that they are being multiplied. So 5 times 5 is 25, and minus, as I told in my previous video, that when you multiply minus with minus, you basically get positive. So when two negatives are being multiplied over here, we will write positive, and 7 into 3 will be 21. So 25 plus 21, so 5 plus 1 is 6, and 2 plus 2 is 4, so 46. So the answer of this evaluation is 46. So we have evaluated this equation. Let's look at another equation. So we have 4y over 9x, right? And we have the same values for x and y. So x is equal to 5 and y is equal to minus 3. So you do the same thing again. You just put these values in the equation. So instead of 4y, we will put minus 3. And instead of x, we will put 5, right? So 4 times minus 3 is, this is positive and this is negative, so positive and negative is negative. So 4 times 3 will be 12. So positive 4 times negative 3 will be minus 12, and then 9 times 5 is 45. And then we simplify this, so these both are divisible by 3. So 3 times 4 is 3 times 4 is 12, and 3 times 15 is 45. So the answer will be minus 4 over 50. So this is the answer of our evaluation. So evaluation just basically means that whatever values of the variables, like in this case the value of the variable x was 5, and in this case the value of the variable y was minus 3. So you basically just have to put the values that are given in the question of the variables into the expressions that we are given also in the question. So you just have to put the values in instead of the variables, right? So that's it for this video. I hope you all learned something. Goodbye.